We just found out that a patient fell.
Let's check it out.
Sir, can you tell us what happened?
Yeah, I lost my balance. I fell and I think I hurt my hip.
Now let's discuss why we're here today. We had a patient fall occur, and we want to learn how to prevent this in the future.
I can't believe one of our patients fell yesterday. What can we do to make sure this does not happen again?
There has to be some tools to help us.
There is a tool to help us. It's called the Model for Improvement. The Model for Improvement is a process improvement tool designed to improve systems and processes. The aim must be time-specific, measurable, and population-specific. We must always have a time frame to complete this by, a way to measure whether we are making an improvement for a population we are concentrating on. In our case, what is the time frame that we want to decrease falls by?
By 6 months.
And how would we measure this?
By the number of patients that fall.
And what is the population that we are concentrating on? Unit 5A
patients.
Right. So our aim or goal would be to eliminate falls with injury to zero within 6 months on Unit 5A.
Hey Sue, how are you?
Hi Franco, good to see you.
Good to see you too.
What have you been up to these days on 5A?
We're working on reducing falls. We're trying to reduce our moderate to higher injury falls to zero within the next 6 months.
Wow, that sounds exciting. Why don't you come by and tell me about it?
Oh, well, thank you for inviting me. I appreciate that.
That was a great example of an elevator speech, and they were able to do it in the time that they had on the elevator with their CEO.
It's a great aim. How much, by when? I'm sure they're gonna make it.
Oh, I have no question, Pat. Outstanding work.
We could test it out with Eunice, because if she's checking in on her patients, you know, she might need help at any time. And she brought up a really good point about communication amongst the staff. So I'll have Eunice explain that to you.
And I think if we can have a walkie-talkie in the unit, that will help me.
Definitely, I think using walkie-talkies is a great idea. And I'm thinking that maybe you can test it with someone else in the unit. I don't know, what do you think?
So we can try that today. We could test that today, and we'll just issue one to the chargers, one to the unit clerk, and to the PCA on the floor, and we'll go over this with them. And so hopefully at the end of this program, then, or this little test, you won't be hearing so many overhead pages on 5A.
Yeah, so we'll measure the coli. Well, I'll meet with you at the end of the shift to see how that went.
Thank you very much.
Well, this is great, guys. Sounds like we have a solid plan here for using the walkie-talkies and studying it, the call light use and the satisfaction of staff, and acting on the results. This is great. Let's do it.
So now that we've identified patients that are at risk for injury if they fall, I was thinking we could use a sign. Would you mind testing this today with one of your patients that are at risk for injury? So at the end of the day, I'll check back in with you and we'll talk about how it went.
I think that's a great idea because we need our patients' feedback. Thank you. Mm-hmm.
So I wanted to study with you today how the sign went with your patient.
Well, today the patient and the family didn't really like the sign. They didn't like the word danger on their wall, and the picture didn't sit well with them either.
Okay.
So I think we need to change it so it's more, picture is more friendly.
That's great feedback. You know, I have an idea what we can use.
Okay.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
So I took your feedback from yesterday and I've created a new sign.
Okay.
And I don't think it's as scary as the other sign. What
okay.
do you think?
I think it's friendly, but let's see what our patients think.
Okay. Will you test it today?
I'll test it on my patient today and I'll let you know how it goes.
Great. Thanks. I wanted to see how it went today with the new sign.
Well, actually, PT came by and said that this might be a little bit too much information to have on the patient's
wow,
door.
That's great feedback.
Yeah.
I didn't even think about that.
Me either.
Okay, let's make a new sign.
Okay.
So I took your feedback from the last couple of days mm-hmm. and made another sign. And I put all the information on the back so that we could protect the patient's privacy.
Mm-hmm.
So what do you think?
I think that we're okay. I think I can test this today with my patient and I'll tell you how it goes.
Great. Thanks.
Thank you.
So how did it go today with the new sign?
You know what? Well, PT loved it, speech, the nurses loved it, patients and their families loved it,
wow.
and I think we're ready to go.
Great. That's great. So I can make a few more of these signs and give them out to several more nurses and we'll try it again tomorrow.
I agree.
Great. Thanks.
Thank you.
Because it's how we learn.
It keeps costs down.
And easier to spread once you've tested and know it works. Here are some tips on how to test change.
Don't forget to collect data every time you test.
You want to fail early and you want to fail often.
Work with the willing.
Be innovative.
Don't try to get buy-in or consensus.
What can we do by next Tuesday?
We aim big.
We test small.
Predict what you think you will learn.
I was at a conference and we were learning about decreasing falls and hourly rounding, but we decided to make it a little more meaningful. What we decided to use is the term rounding with a purpose. That's what we call it here at San Francisco General. We started with the three P's, which is pain, potty, position, and we did some testing with that. And I was one of the nurses that tested it, and I had five patients that I was doing my rounding on, and I realized that one of my patients, he didn't have any pain. He didn't need any assistance with going to the bathroom, and he was independent and could reposition himself, but he had been here a really long time, and what he really needed was just somebody to talk to. And through testing, we learned that we needed to add the fourth P, personal needs. We're at the point now where we have really seen some great results on our unit, on 5A. And today is actually the day that we are spreading to 4D, which is another med-surg unit. And it's very exciting. The goal is to eventually continue spreading rounding throughout all of med-surg and decrease falls across the hospital.
So you think you can change?
Dancing, dancing, dancing.
She's a
band, move it, baby. Automatic, systematic, full of self-contained. Tuned and channeled to your vibes. Captivating, stimulating. She's such a sexy lady, filled with space safe design.
She's moving, she's grooving, dancing until the music stops now. Yeah.